in trouble, sugar, moving down the line. I come apart, babe, but that's okay, 'cause trouble man don't get in my way.
Good evening, greetings, and welcome to the Militant Negro YouTube channel. My name is JB, and once again, I feel the need to make a video, a voice video, about all the racism I see in the United States of America directed toward the president-elect Donald Trump. Now, yes, I know Mr. Trump is a racist. I believe in my soul that he is a racist. I have no doubts whatsoever about this. But Mr. Trump won the election fair and square. He is the president-elect. And I think people need to back up off of their racist rhetoric and give the guy a due chance. It's just ridiculous to me that people label Donald Trump as the future problem of American politics and of the office of president when they would have elected Hillary Clinton, who would have also been a problem. Hillary's actions as Secretary of State were horrific. She's responsible for millions of people dead abroad. She is responsible for starting wars and killing civilians. She is a proponent of Barack Obama's drone wars, which indiscriminately bombs and kills civilians, women, children, non-military personnel. And yet still, you would have been just perfectly fine with having her in the White House. That really strikes me as ironic and stupid and a double standard, hypocritical, you name it. Those are the things that it strikes me as. You want to put this woman in the White House. People are upset. People are protesting. Hashtag not my president, directed toward President-elect Donald Trump. Yet and still, I will say it again, and I have been saying it ever since the election night results, Hillary Clinton would be a worse choice than Donald Trump. No matter who Donald Trump picks to be on his cabinet, no matter who Donald Trump selects as his people he goes to for advice, no matter who Donald Trump surrounds himself with, he is a much better, less lethal president for the world than Hillary Clinton would have been. If you don't believe me, just look up Hillary Clinton's record. Look up all the things she said and done ever since her husband was president, ever since she became a senator. Check her out. Look up her record as Secretary of State to see all the carnage she imposed on the world. Consider yourselves blessed and lucky if you live in the United States and you do not have Hillary Rodham Clinton as your president. Hopefully, she will fade off into the sunset or go to prison, whichever. But just feel really fortunate she's not in the White House as president, because it would be a whole lot worse than anything Donald Trump can dream of doing. And all this protesting and all this hand-wringing and all this hysteria and all this fake false concern that people are showing over Trump's presidency is stupid. It's uncalled for. It is unnecessary, but above all, it is unwarranted. The man is not in office, hasn't been in office, hasn't taken the oath of office, and yet still you have people telling you the sky is falling, that there will be an apocalypse the moment he walks into the Oval Office. And if you think for one minute those people behind the presidency, those men with real power, are going to allow Donald Trump to screw up their plans for America, you are insane. Hillary Rodham Clinton was going to do the exact same thing that Donald Trump is going to do, because the exact same people that control Donald Trump right now and for the next 4 years would have been the same folks controlling Hillary Clinton had she won on Tuesday night and been elected president. The game has not changed. The major players in the game have not changed. They're still the same people. The power brokers who make America run are the same people for whoever is in the White House. You don't believe that? Just think about Barack Obama's 8 years in the White House. Did he do any of the things he promised to do in 2008 during his campaign? Very few things was Barack Obama able to accomplish. We want to blame it on an obstructionist Congress. But you know what? The American voters put those senators and congressmen on Capitol Hill. So the American voters are directly responsible for anything that Barack Obama did not get done, as well as Barack Obama being responsible, because he knew the game before he was elected. He would have never been allowed to win if he had not agreed to play the game by the rules set down by the Caucasian wealthy billionaire businessmen who run the United States of America. You can't be elected president in the USA unless you agree to the terms set down by the people who run America. And it ain't no people of color running America. The president does not run America. The president is a figurehead, as I have said for years. He's the public face of the people behind the presidency, the people with the actual power. So all your protesting, all your being upset and concerned, all the issues you have with Barack Obama going out and Donald Trump coming in instead of Hillary Clinton are bullshit. Because Hillary was going to do the same exact thing that Donald is going to do. And all this talk about walls and fences and deportations, Donald Trump doesn't have the power to do that just because he willy-nilly decides to do it. There is a Congress and a Senate who are the checks and balances in place so that the executive branch can't run roughshod over America. Checks and balances, that's what it's all about. I hope this helps put some of your fears and concerns to bed. Take a deep breath. Take a vacation. Relax. Clear your heads. Get some sleep. Because you've all been very busy since November 8th, 2016, Tuesday night election. You've all been very busy working yourselves up into a frenzy. Stop it. Just chill out. There is no reason to think the sky is falling and the sun is not going to rise tomorrow and everybody's going to be sent off to concentration camps and locked away and deported and put in slavery chains. It's not going to happen. The United States is going to continue to run pretty much as it has for the last 100 years. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you subscribe. Hope you like this. Namaste. Be safe. Stay well. And stay out the streets protesting before you get hurt. Peace out. Much love. Don't forget to take a deep breath, y'all.